Hi everybody, welcome to another Csec Cxc Geography Made Simple. Today I'll be sharing with you how you go about calculating four figure and six figure grid references on a map. So here I have a map of Lesser Antilles with a scale of 1 to 25,000, Point Michel, right? Okay, now this is what I call a topographic map, right? And in another video I will share with you the dynamics as to what is a topographic map, but for today we are focusing on four figure and six figure grid references. Okay, now every map normally comes with Eastings and Northings. Now what are Eastings? Now Eastings are those numbers that are found either at the base of the map going across or at the top of the map going across. A lot of breeze blowing, so therefore I am trying to hold down the map. I don't have a glass table. That is what we normally use when we are actually doing map work, a glass table, alright? But for today, I'm just using some books to hold on the map, and hopefully this will actually convey what I am trying to say. Okay, so the Eastings are found at the base of the map or at the top of the map, right? And then you have what you call the Northings that are found at either ends of the map, right? Now, what are Eastings? Eastings are those numbers, like these numbers, where you, is 65, 66, 67, 68, and it continues, right? These are Eastings. Now, why are they called Eastings? They are called Eastings because they increase in value going to the east, okay? Now, we have what you call Northings. Now, these Northings, calculation of numbers are at the side, at either side, the left or the right side, and they normally increase in value or increase in numbers going up to the northern section of the map. All right, so here you have 80 81 80 81 82, and it goes up all the way to 88, right? Okay, so in writing the four figure and the six figure grid references of a map, you must always remember that the Eastings are these numbers, the one at the base and the one at the top, right? It's the same numbers, right? But some map, for shortcut, they will just put on one side, the numbers on one side, right? So you have the numbers forming like a L, like set of numbers here, set of numbers here. You can work with that because everything is practically the same thing, right? So the Eastings are always written before the Northings. Remember, the Eastings are always written before the Northings. Okay, so I am trying to find the four figure grid reference for, let's say, a Hagley, right? So the place I'm trying to find is Hagley, right? And I'm trying to find a four figure grid reference. Now Hagley, four figure grid reference, starting with the Easting. Hagley is, remember, the box are, like for example, this would be 65, this would be 66, this would be 67 going along, not the other way around. All right, so in finding Hagley, this is Hagley. So I found Hagley on the map, right? And I'm trying to find a four figure grid reference. So what I do, I follow the line, coming down, and in following the line, I realize that the Eastings for Hagley is 71. So I put 71 as the Eastings. Now, I have to find the Northings for Hagley. Now this is Hagley, right? So I'm finding the Northings for Hagley. So I'll go along this line and I search for the number that's here. And the number that's here is 84, right? So therefore, the four-figure grid reference for Hagley would be 71 coming up here, all the way here, right, to 71.84. So in short, what's happening is that Hagley, let's say Hagley starts with H and it's within the northings of 84 and the eastings of 71, right? When I actually try to triangulate, how can I find Hagley? Using the lines, I realize that Hagley is nicely triangulated with an easting of 71 and a northing of 84. Alright, so let's look at finding six-figure grid reference. Now, six-figure grid reference is a little bit more technical in that you now will have to calculate an additional two digit in addition to that in which you will more than likely have on the map itself. So let's look at some exact location now. Now let's look at the post office. Let's look at the post office right there near, I am not 100% sure how to pronounce this word, but let's look at the post office here in Beriqua. If you are familiar with the place, probably you'll pronounce it better. So we are trying to find a six-figure grid reference for the post office at Beriqua. Alright, so let me write down the place. This is a post office. PO means post office, right? Post office at Beriqua. Right, Beriqua. So I'm trying to find a six-figure grid reference, right? Okay, so in finding the six-figure grid reference for Beriqua, at the post office at Beriqua, right, I first have to look for my eastings. And in looking for my eastings, I first find the place, right? And the place is Beriqua. Because a question like this will tell you the place. So you look for the place, you look for the post office. So this is the post office, right? Then you'll follow there and do not get mixed up with this line here. I think this is a degree line of a different nature, right? This is something totally different. No, we are looking for the post office. So the nearest line for the post office, that's the grid reference, the line would be 72. How do I get 72? Following the line coming down, I realize that 72 is at the base, right? So I can check at the base, or I can check at the top and I will see the 72, right? So the post office is at Eastings 72. So the Eastings equal 72, right? Okay, so we are here and we have actually identified the first two grid reference for six-figure grid reference for the post office at Beriqua. Okay, I pronounce it well, right? Okay, bearing in mind that you cannot number from 1 to 10, right? In the sense that if you should divide this box, right, into 10, right, you're going to end up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that means if anything is found over, let's say here, right, that means you'd have seven-figure grid reference instead of six-figure grid reference. So instead of start counting from 1, what you would do, you start counting from 0. All right, I say this to say that the first two grid reference number is 72, right? So I have 72 here written down. So I have 72 here written down, right? So 72 is written down. Right? And the post office is found right in the line. Right in the line here. Right? So more than likely you would have 720. Right? So it would be 720. And I need the other three numbers. And this is the post office, guys. The post office is located here. This is the post office, right? The other line is 84. So it's 72 0 84, and I'm going to be counting, going up. I'm counting the spaces, guys. Do not look at the line itself. Look at the spaces. And we are counting from 0. So it is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, and 9 is supposed to end up here, not 10. Right? So anything found right here will be 0. Alright, so I'm continuing, I'm counting, right? And I am counting, and this looks like about 4. So it would be probably about 4. And how I get 4 is that I am now counting, instead of counting this way, like the Eastings, you'll be counting on this line, right? The Northings, you'll be counting this line, you'll be counting this way, right? So you have to divide this box in 10 equal spaces. So normally what I do is to divide the space, divide the box in half, and then now I would move either up or down. Now looking at the post office, which is here, it's below the 5 belt, so I would estimate that it would be probably about 4, right? So therefore it is 72 0 84 4, and that would be the 6-figure grid reference for the post office of Berikwa. Right? I hope that this actually helped help you in understanding 6-figure grid reference. However, let's look at a simple box here. Let's say that you have a box. For those persons still wondering what am I speaking about. And let's say that you have here being H meaning hospital. Right? And this is 01, and this is 10, and this is 20. And this is 02, right? All of this here, Eastings. All of this here, Northings, right? Okay, so you're trying to find what's the 6-figure grid reference for H. So H equal 01, right? And then now you actually start counting. This will be 0, right? This will be 1. So therefore, this will be roughly about, no, this will be 0. This look too big, right? Alright, so it would be roughly about, yeah, this would be 5, right? This would be 0, this would be 1, 2, so it divides this in 5 spaces, right? To me, this looks like it borders on about, probably about 3, right? So I would write probably about 0, 1, 3, and then I would write 1, 0, and I will count. This is a half mark, right? This would be 6, right? And then 7, 8, 9, yeah, it's definitely 6, right? So it would be 0, 1, 3, 1, 0, 6. So this would be the 6-figure grid reference for H. It's hope that you understand a little bit clearer with regards to calculating 6-figure grid reference. Join me next time as I do some more, as I share some more, as I indulge some more in some practical geography. Peace out. Catch you next time. Bye-bye for now.